Hello to everyone, Mary here from Ireland with our weekly Your Journey Back to Love reading. And this week I'm using Doreen Virtue's They're Well Used, they're my very first deck, Daily Guidance from Your Angels deck. Purple deck, purple cardigan, it's a higher connection with spirit. And I'm interested to find out if we get the same energies as my last video of the energies around me at the moment, or what's ahead, what guidance have they got for the following week. All right, lovely. I need 5 this week and I don't know why. Okay, that's why. Endings. We'll start with the last card. Time to go. So it's about endings and beginnings. So it's reviewing your life where you are at the moment and what needs to end. Is it a thought pattern? Is it something you're doing over and over that's bringing you to the same place that isn't serving your highest good? Is it a job? Is it a hobby that's not floating your boat anymore? Is there something new you have to bring into your life that you've forgotten about and that you need to take up again? Are there new places to be and places to go? Different for everybody, but endings and beginnings, definitely. The sun sets and rises each day, and it's the same with the avenues in your life. See the beauty within each sunset in your life, and know that the sun will also rise again tomorrow. Endings are merely the start of a new beginning, and we are with you through each phase and cycle. Okay, so lots of changes. In my car yesterday, or on my birthday day, I saw 5 fives on the mileage. And on a truck, I saw 5 sevens in a telephone number. So my God, I said, huge change is coming. So watch out for your signs as well that spirit are sending you in whichever way you receive your signs. And endings are new beginnings. So they're all for the highest good. Let go as easily as you can and feel your feelings. Let them surface, write them down, speak them out, and just let go. Okay, are we going? Yeah, we'll go backwards. The last card first and the second last next. Cupid. So this is about relationships. The last moons were all about relationships as well. So not necessarily romantic, but in this reading, romantic. Relationships ending, stepping back from people that don't need to be in your life anymore. It doesn't say that they're going to be gone forever. They can come back when you've grown and they've grown. Look at your past romantic relationships. What patterns did you repeat in those relationships? Are you repeating them again now? Is there something you have to end? Is there a relationship you have to end? Is there something you have to change? So Cupid, and this, as I said, isn't necessarily about romantic love, but it can be dependent on each person's path, but love. Are you loving yourself? Are you respecting yourself in these relationships? You've got to do that for you first, and you've got to be totally in love with you first, your life. Respect yourself, love yourself, put yourself first, not selfishly but selflessly, for your higher good, and to keep your energy high and bright and full of peace and love. So, you know, you first. We send great waves of love into your heart and mind, awakening your love for life itself. Your clear decision to accept and enjoy romance has triggered this reawakening, and to accept love of every description. Allow yourself to spontaneously celebrate love in all of its glorious aspects. So love and relationships this week, and endings and new beginnings, and just zoning in a bit more clearly on what's not working and what needs to be let go, what needs to be changed, and thought patterns, belief systems, and just letting go more. Like my energy video, see if anything there resonates with you too. Fresh air, and it helped me the other day as well, sitting out and letting the sea breeze just blow the energy away. So fresh air and eating from the earth as well to lighten our energy. Your body needs refreshment from oxygenated air generated by grass, trees, plants and flowers. Spend time outside today as near to Mother Nature's cradle as possible. Open your curtains and windows to refresh your home as well. So it's just helping with your energy and helping with what's going on in your life. This will bring a lightness to you and a help. The trees and plants and nature are there to help us as well. Be near water if that is what you're drawn to too. And moving forward, they're talking about the endings and beginnings as well. And moving forward, have confidence. And like I went to a deeper level of, I know my angels and guides are there all the time. I'm always talking to somebody. Sometimes I don't know who I'm speaking to, but I know they're there. Archangel Michael is there. And they have given me the strength and the confidence to keep walking forward, because I know what I have cleared, I won't have to clear at that level again. Move forward. If it comes up again, look at it again. Okay, where have I to go with this? What's it about? Why is it coming up again? Let go more again. It's a process. Everything won't go of a shot, because your body, your mind, your energy will not be able for huge clearings all at once. It's a process. So have confidence. Moving forward does not necessarily require you to have confidence in yourself. Confidence in God is enough, in the universe, in your angels, your guides, your loved ones, along with knowing that God works through you and with you in all ways. Lean upon us if your confidence wavers, and we will buoy your courage and faith. So these endings and new beginnings do require courage and faith, and you will link with the energy you need outside in fresh air, lighter energy, fairies of course as well, but angels, earth energy help that way. And just look at what has to go and change, and it could be just a change of, well, I never go outside, I will go outside now. Very simple, but other stuff too. I know people are going through big changes at the moment, and it's just trust in your inner instinct. And even if others think you're making a wrong decision, as long as when you're making that decision, it brings, God, that feels so much better. As long as that brings, your decisions bring that feeling to you, that's what you need to be doing, and that's where you need to be. So never mind anybody outside yourself. Trust your inner guidance, your angels, your guides, nature, your little bubble, to make your decisions and to cope with what's going on. Now you don't need to be looking at what everybody else is doing or asking other people's opinion. Just ask spirit for who you need and what you need and what you need to read, what you need to hear, where you need to be. Just trust your thoughts and your ideas and your inner knowingness on what's next for you. I put up a video of Oprah the other day. What is my next right step? That's all you need to know. The next step. You don't need to be looking off 2 years down the road and where you're going to be and what's going to happen, because you'd have no idea, no control. What is my next right step? What brings me to this place of, that feels so much better. Okay? So romance, time to go, fresh air, have confidence, and shower of abundance. So as you know, abundance is that feeling. It's not necessarily money, money, money. It's just everything that's full of love and peace and joy and happiness and everything that's good. Feelings, thoughts, people, places, money, you are provided for. Be open to receive. To heal your financial situation, first give us your worries concerning money. We will guide you in order to show you how to create and accept abundance. As we work together, your financial situation will heal as fast as you'll allow. Now, I know that's our energy on earth at the moment. We need money, physical money to buy and sell, etc. But going through the rest of this reading, it's abundance in all things. It's not just the money. And when you become confident and trusting and full of faith, everything will flow. Everything you need will flow to you, including the money. Okay, and those relationships that you need in your life. So love and light to you. Have a great week. All my information is down below. If you need me, you know where I am. My services are there. My books are there. My contact details are there. And as I say, I'll be in Nottingham from next Thursday to Saturday, coming home Sunday. So ping me up if you're in the area too. I'll have one deck of cards with me, I think. So love and light to you. Bye-bye now.